Hi, is your laptop so slow that you don't want to use it anymore? My wife's computer needs a couple of minutes to start Windows, and it's become pretty slow in general. The hardware is not that bad, so I decided to buy a solid-state drive and give it a real performance boost. In this video, I will show you how to install an SSD in a laptop and how you can use your old hard drive as additional storage space. Let's get started. Before you start doing anything, flip over the laptop and disconnect the battery. Flip it back and hold the power button for about 2 seconds to discharge the capacitors. Now we want to locate the hard drive, so turn it over one more time and look for one of these labels. In most cases you will find a cover like this one, but there are also other possibilities. In some laptops there is only one big sheet of plastic that covers the whole bottom. In others, the hard drive is hidden under the keyboard. If you can't locate the hard drive, Google your laptop's model number with a keyword like disassemble or disassembly. There are tons of tutorials and videos for almost any brand and model, which will lead you to the hard drive placement. When you finally find the hard drive, go ahead and pull it out. Remove all screws and release your hard drive. Be aware that there are basically two types of hard drives on laptops, 7 and 9.5mm thick. It's a good idea to check your hard drive thickness before you buy a new SSD that just won't fit. Take your new SSD and install it in the hard drive mount. Connect it to your laptop and close the cover. You have just replaced your old hard drive with a brand new solid state drive. If you still want to use your hard drive as additional storage space, you have at least two options. You can use it in an external 2.5-inch USB enclosure. The hard drive installation is very straightforward. Just put it inside . Fasten a couple of screws and you're ready to connect it to one of your free USB ports. Windows will install the drivers automatically and you should be able to access all your files. Your old hard drive has just become portable. If you use your optical drive just from time to time, or don't use it at all, you will like the second option. You can buy a hard drive enclosure which replaces the optical drive. Just remove these two screws and you can slide out your optical drive. These come in two thickness variations, 9.5 and 12.7 millimeters, so be sure to measure your optical drive before you buy the enclosure. Connect your old hard drive. And fasten all four screws. Unscrew the angle bracket and attach it to the new enclosure. Unfold the paperclip like this. And press it into the emergency eject hole. The tray should pop open when you press the release mechanism. Unclip this front face plate, but take your time and don't use too much force so we won't break the plastic clips. Attach it to the hard drive enclosure. Slide it in. Fasten the two screws. And you're done. If you ever needed an optical drive, there are many external USB devices on the market, like for example this one. Simply plug it into a USB port and you can start using your CDs and DVDs again. Now you are ready to install the operating system on your new solid-state drive. If you don't want to start from scratch, you can also clone your system partition from your old hard drive. I hope you have found this video helpful, and if so, please share it with your friends and family. Subscribe to my channel so you won't miss my new videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.